Sacred throws the hammer at him. Chip away at the bristleback, who is stacking up some quill sprays, but I don't know if he can escape from this, even with stick charge and tangos. He's gonna die here to the shield and a few hits out from Panda and Matthew.
And another first blood for Matthew.
The quills are, they're annoying.
Okay, the they're gonna give it to Pakaz.
Pakaz gets it. He walked all the way from bottom rune towards the top triangle.
This is where Boot...
Not going as poorly for LGD as maybe it should be. Viper suffering in the last hits, but Luna also having a difficult time getting there. Both of them with seven last hits. Combo from Matthew, though. Chuck the Tusk back into the creep wave. The tank team counteracted a little bit by the shield, but the poison attacks will get them a trade. Every time you trade like this, you're getting more experience for LGD in the hands of fewer heroes.
PSG LGD should be happy about the trade. Is available.
Yeah, pre-level 6 on the Ember Spirit. A few stacks of that napalm on him. Gets the flame guard off, but the toss across into the river. And nothing to say with a good two-man chains. Ooh, he holds them back, but the napalm's going to keep on coming. Firefly and the flame break missing. Should still be able to grab this kill, though. There's nothing to say. Tracked back by Alone and Matthew. A good rotation from the Tiny. But look at where Ame's playing now. There's no
they
way Sacred
that
could...
he does not have a TP, so Ame diving real hard. Slow down. Should be okay. This is going to be Vanguard Bristleback and on the bottom lane.
Oh, wow, yeah. Faith Bian. A killing spree on this Viper. Not what you like to see as a Thunder fan. Especially when they try lane against him. But Alone's rotation top. In onto the Bristleback. He's got his Vanguard and 8 stick charges. Quite a lot of magic damage coming his way, though. So Ame under the Firefly and the Celestial Hammer burning him alive. The Bristleback.
Sitting inside the Firefly and Celestial Hammer, way too much damage. This is gonna be probably a game where he gets both Vanguard and Hood. Fate Beyond, this is a big pickup.
Yeah, kill the Viper, get the spree. Interesting. Oh, mate, turned into Suckling Pig up top, respawns, should return to his lane.
Early against the Batrider, just follow him. Nothing to say, still level 5.
And a lasso comes out of Alone. Yeah, they got stacks of napalm on him. Firefly and a fairy fire. Chen can't do anything really to save him here. The toss forward sends the Batrider in towards the Ember Spirit. Did dodge it, but Alone still picks up the kill. Gets away from the tower attacks and 4 stacks up on Yi's Chen. Matthew trying to finish him off with the punches. Will get the kill and the snowball not landing, but Alone trapped in the shards.
Jin Q, what a play. Places down Observer Ward to get the glimpse of vision of Batrider. Uses a snowball.
Batrider, very adept at clearing out these juicy stacks. Chen has made for him. Alone, though, going to get chained up and LGD responding. I don't want to give this up for free. Nothing to say with the help of Faith Beyond. They are chasing back on the Batrider and Matthew, just dying to the Bristleback. Alone's Firefly has run out. He's got 9 stick charges here, but Ame and Faith Beyond slowing him down to a crawl. Batrider saved by the Abaddon, but in comes a snowball. Ah, the Solar Guardian. Good heal onto Alone. Stacking up a lot of damage onto the Bristleback. And the Sacred. He lands the hammer. Stormbreaker on Jin Q, but he'll die, saving his buddy. One hero drops. Jin Q gone, but Yi. The Chen survives while the dive
no
keeps
mana.
On going.
For shield needs 5 more mana.
Alone, he just keeps getting these stick uses out. Faith Bian and Ame, they're dropping pretty low. No
Firefly's
going to
be ready again.
The Luna's rotated in. Thunder bring the numbers. A double kill for the Luna.
Almost a full team wipe 8 minutes into the game. They're so slowed by every single spell on their side.
They'll get
him.
The Remnant to finish him. Nothing to say, he turns it back on them, a double kill for him now. But with the Avalanche Toss, the Lucent Beam, there's no escape for this Ember Spirit now, and Pakaz continues his streak. For a lesson.
Nothing to say. Giving away a lot of gold.
It's
but
a
these
5 for 4.
It is multiple saves. They can use like Flame Break to throw people away. Abaddon needs more levels, potentially a toss back, and the turnaround play from Dawnbreaker ulti, as we see here.
Yeah, but the Hand of God, maybe a bit of damage and tankiness from Ame, not enough to allow him to survive.
Question, do you think Ame buys casual cloak right now, because there's a lot of magical damage coming out from Thunder Awaken.
Yeah, he might just. We've seen that Vanguard Hood build, right? As Y gets cleared through. Alone, moving now towards Jin Q. Matthew get punched around and slowed down by the poison attacks, but they're tossing Q back into the middle of three of them. In comes Nothing to Say, though. The Ember Spirit able to open up on the Dawnbreaker, chase back through the trees, and hunt even more. Alone does pick up a double kill, but Thunder are going to lose three in the trade-off there. Faith Beyond's courier dying in the midst of battle. Akaz continues farming away towards his BKB.
Every single time Faith Beyond and Nothing to Say show up in a fight, it feels like the fight is over for Thunder Awakened, and you know it's going to be a bloodbath.
Yeah, both teams really scrapping and brawling. Arme doing a good job here, focusing objectives with his Bristleback, even though he's died a couple of times. He's 1-4 and 3, and under the Eclipse, make that 5. Time. He chased down by Sacred. Starbreaker in, and they'll pick off the check. Pakaz. Another streak being built up by himself.
Pakaz can carry the game with Luna, being wait for another set of BKBs. Dawnbreaker will have one in 2-3 minutes, depending how much farm she manages to get. Batrider needs like 4 minutes, so if they want to put a little bit more pressure out on the map and on PSG LGD, I think it's time to go now.
That's got to be one of the scariest things. LGD is a 5-man unit, smoked up, roaming up top. They've killed Sacred. Panda who gets his ult down, but Yi with the Hand of God keeps him alive. They've taken down Faith Beyond, though, with this Eclipse. Pakaz sprints forward towards Jin Q. TP cancelled, comes in time with a lasso. Alone helps Pakaz pick up a double kill. And Thunder with that buyback on Sacred, they do win a team fight. It was incredibly scary just watching LGD 5-man smoke towards them. But without the Bristleback there, unable to sustain this extended team fight with the buyback of the Dawn.
Buyback used, Pakaz did use Eclipse to be able to get some damage going. Maybe they will not go for Roche right now because there is no Eclipse, even though the BKB is online, so they can wait. Eclipse is a big chunk of damage. Oh, they waited him on Remnant.
Found Nothing to Say.
All right, where are the tips at? For a
lesson. What lesson is that?
Dire structures are fortified.
LGD. Still 2k net worth lead for them. Tossed back onto an illusion. Nicely done by Matthew. And now the follow through from Pakaz, looking for yet another kill to add to his list. Sacred grabs it though. GQ will shard block and run back behind his tier 2. Deep vision there from Thunder as well. The Luna is such a vacuum of farm, taking everything. As Matthew makes the jump in, lasso there into the toss, but the Hand of God, the heal on to Nothing to Say, might allow him to slip away from this with a slide of fist and jump to the Remnant. He's perfectly fine. And the turnaround from Faith Beyond and the rest of LGD, they're pummeling into Sacred, but he's TP'd out. Matthew, the only death so far, but Pakaz with a BKB Eclipse, he can't stand his ground. Arme with some massive whacks of his mates, looking for Pandamu, and this is it. LGD with one team fight victory have completely turned the tables on Thunder.
And now it's
alone.
Roche time.
He's dead too.
They invested everything, try to go on Ember Spirit, Lasso, Tossback, Dawnbreaker ulti. In the end,
he is. Bristleback showing those here in this tournament. Straight up to high ground is LGD. 2 minutes 20 on Aegis, Catapult Wave behind him, and Thunder with a lot to contend with. Matthew, Avalanche, toss the Tusk, send him back into the lasso, dragging him towards Fountain. Pakaz gonna take one kill. He did lose the tiny though, and the buildings are still being broken. Oh man, Aegis doesn't really care too much about anything.
There's so much
fight. Got some decent jump, but they need the tiny to land the perfect Avalanche toss, probably on the Ember. And I'll wait on their high ground. Arme breaks the smoke. Maybe for the first kill here on the Bristleback. But the damage into Matthew. The Hand of God comes, but Jin Q still falls. He went in trying to snowball save as the dive from LGD comes in behind tier 3. Pakaz is able to stand there and launch the glaives in towards Arme. The Bristleback maybe a little bit too deep now. Thunder split them. They've gone into the back lines, aiming Faith Beyond with the Firefly
into
there,
Eclipse,
and Arme
he goes
dead inside the Eclipse. LGD going a step too far, and Thunder, it can't be too far away from feeling good about this now. Faith Beyond gonna get found on the defense of the high ground. And don't underestimate Thunder with their defense.
Always playing against Tiny, trying to siege the high ground. Could be a bit tricky. Not that much lockdown from PSG LGD. Pakaz Going on Jinkyu, Snowball not available yet. Oh, Hand of God.
The Hand of God's there. And now Pakar's in trouble. Penitent's there. He's going to eclipse BKB. Kills off Jinkyu. Yi dead to this Pakar's Luna as well. He's 1v4ing and almost winning. Dawnbringer's coming with a Solar Guardian. BKB TP not successful. Army offering far too much damage and Thunder. Oh, they've been baited in by their Luna.
They should have not helped him out. He did manage to get out the super tanky Shen before, how effective it is. And seems like it's becoming more popular.
Is the Chen not leveling up his talents either, just going for stats?
No, he's level 14.
Oh, he's, oh right, okay. Poor Chen. Oh, the toss back, lasso, and it's cancelled. Can't drag him to Fountain. And Army, his BKB on. Move towards Matthew, couple of taps, breaks apart the rock. Jinkyu on his way back as well. As the barracks wide open and focused down by LGD.
Alone tips Y immediately. I'm not sure if he was aware of this one. He's like, what the hell is going on? Where is my lasso? Then he figures out there is Aghanim Scepter on Chen. Because Y didn't show any items on his Chen, so wanted to have this surprise effect. And Luna dies, this means game.
No buybacks. Yeah, no buybacks at all. And even if they had the hope of staying in the tournament, they're all locked in place now. As, of course, LGD had previously secured themselves upper bracket. Fnatic, OG, and Outsiders will join them with RNG and Team Liquid going into that lower bracket. And unfortunately, Talon, Thunder, and Sonics are all eliminated.
Yeah, is this like one of the few times where after the group stage, we don't have any type of...